Rajala University College should be given priority. So he need not worry himself, because the fiber will pass very close to Jala University College as it heads for the eastern region and finally Biedu, close to the Liberian border. So Jala University College is in very good stead. Even the World Bank is also interested in having Jala University College on board, both at Jala campus and the Bo campus itself. So you need not worry. About the young man who spoke about Mami Yeli not knowing the details of this. You see, the fact of the matter is that we're talking about a new technology. And even the educated people in Freetown sometimes find it difficult to be able to grasp the whole concept of the fiber itself. Why is it the fiber and not the satellite? Because the satellite is very expensive. And we want people to have access to more telecommunications facilities. And therefore, we prefer to use the fiber. To us, it's important. So Mami Yeli will understand, because our project, we have what we call the post-landing programs. In other words, after landing the submarine fiber and after building the backbone and the terrestrial system, what do you do with it so that the people of Sierra Leone can benefit from it?
So what do you say to the question that you speak politics before issues?
No, well, of course, I do not speak politics before issues. This is a very technical topic which must be handled technically, and I have no reason to bring politics into it, except to state that it was the whole idea of President Koroma, who flew to Addis Ababa to meet the World Bank people and to plead with them that, look, my country lost out in SAT-3 and it's lost out in other fiber programs because we are busy fighting a war, and I do not want to miss this one again.
So that's why we have the fiber here.
In less than 1 week, the consultants were here to start the project going.
Okay, I want to remind our listeners that they can join us on the program by sending a message to +232 78 546 474 +232 78 546 474. Of course, if you're within Sierra Leone, 078 54 64 74, or you can send us an email to www.facebook.com/thetonightshow.slbc or www.twitter.com/edwardarena and be part of the Tonight Show. Now, your ministry is regarded as one of such ministries that continues to make inroads into the development of Sierra Leone and continues to bolster the country's respect in the international community. This is according to UO Times, but the average Sierra Leonean is still asking for proof to substantiate this statement. Can you provide any?
Well, all I can see here is that we have landed the submarine fiber in this country. That's history by itself. We are building the terrestrial backbone. We have reactivated the Sierra Leone News Agency, which was moribund for the past 10, 15 years. We have reactivated the government printing department. We have brought in new printing machines, about 10 of them. We have given it life again. We have made sure that we have recruited new information officers, sending them to the provinces to make sure that they have connection with the people. We have brought in a new management contract for Seratel to reactivate Seratel itself, and we have made them NATCOM, one of the strongest regulatory authorities in the whole of West Africa. We have quite a number of activities where we have put in place structures to create the Secretariat for Attitudinal Change, which has a whole lot of support from the President himself and which is doing very well. We have beefed up the Office of the Government Spokesman, which has made the Office of the Government Spokesman a very, very effective tool for communication in the government. It's important that we have all of these things.
Okay, now that's
and I do not take all the credit. I also would want to give the credit to my colleagues in Cabinet who have always supported me. I also would want to give the credit to the workers in the ministry, my functionaries
who have already supported Alaji,
us.
It's in public that your ministry sold part of the piece of land where the landing station is located at Lumley to Falcon International Investment Company. How true is this allegation?
That is not true. Some people who are neighbors to us encroached on that land, and which we have since taken back because it is our land. And we want to make it very, very clear that we do not go to petty things like that to sell land. In the first place, we need that land for further expansion. Our ministry is a ministry of activities. It's a ministry that wants to develop.
But Alhaji, if the land was not sold by either you or someone within the ministry, how is it possible that such a government investment site will be fitted with by an investment company?
No, that is not true, because in the first place, let's just make it very clear. We wanted that land, and the environmental impact assessment made it very clear that it was that land that was very useful. Close to us, we had these people who were the original owners, quote unquote, of this land. It was they who gave us that piece of land for us to build a landing station. And during the process, after the South Africans had completed the construction of the landing station, we found it very difficult to understand why these people veered into what should have been part of the land for the landing station. We went there, we protested and protested, and in the end, we had to use force to take back what is ours.
Okay, now the fiber project has its extensions, including one laptop per child program. How realistic is such a project, considering the fact that you have a little over 2 months in office?
No, it is realistic, and Mark, we are going to come back to power, so what is wrong with that? So there's always going to be continuity. I may not be in the ministry, but once we return to power, there'll be continuity. One thing that is very clear is that we continue to promote the president's agenda for change, bringing new ideas to make sure that the people of this country benefit. And the laptop per child, to us, it's a reality. We have done the experiment. We have looked at some schools which are going to benefit from this as an experiment. We have identified some schools which are going to quickly benefit from this very soon, 1 month, 2 months from now. We have taken, for example, the FSG in Freetown. The Freetown Secondary School for Girls is going to benefit from this. Okay. We have taken the Shirenka Secondary School in Patlaka. We have taken the Kenema Secondary School in Kenema, the boys' school there. We've taken the Maburuka Boys' School, the Bash Memorial School in Makeni, and the Hafford School. A good number of these schools, we are using them for experimental purposes.
Let's find out what people are saying now there. This one says, Uncle Ibi, just go ahead. We CRL unions are very slow to understand your hard work. May God bless you. It's coming from Jokanu Neil Silk. And another one here says, Bravo, Ibi, you are one of the ministers in our government. Is the fiber going to cover all of this nation? I'll sign Cheku Conte. And another one which just come in says, IB will not speak out of politics as he is a machine for APC, not for issues. George in Freetown. And another one says, Koto IB, keep it up. You are an accolade minister. Keep it up. It's coming from Mariama. Well, I don't think we need to go online because we have a little more time to go. Of course, you've just heard from those messages.
Yes, okay, the fiber will cover the whole country eventually. Like I told you, that we have the optical backbone that will link the landing station to the rest of the country. And then, of course, we have the terrestrial system. There's going to be yet another system to be introduced by another set of Chinese. And when you put all of this into context and take them into consideration, then, of course, we are going to have this fiber all over the country. Mark you, we have a whole program. We have 150-something chiefdoms in this country. We want to be very certain that each chiefdom headquarters has what we call a telecenter, a place where you can go to and have access to the internet, have access to a telephone, and have access to a digital television system.
And finally, Alhaji, in 30 seconds, because we're time-bound, it's almost over.
What a pity. I could have said more.
I know you can.
Yes.
But finally, sir, many CRL unions believe that since you became a minister, you are now on the other side of the coin in terms of the repeal of the Public Order Act of 1965, which you do fought for tooth and nail when you were still a practicing journalist. Do you agree?
Well, the fact of the matter is that the law is law. I took a position at the time. I thought that something ought to be done to make communication easier for everybody. And once I assumed office, the first thing I did was to convince the president for us to give the SLBS, for example, independent status.
Are you saying you're still supporting the fight?
The fight is on. We are going to fight.
Supporting the fight?
I am supporting it. Parliament will support us, and one of these days we will get there.
All right, many thanks to you, sir, for joining us this evening. Well, I'm sure it has been heated, but I'm sure you love it. That's why you sent your messages. Well, that's how we wrap things up. My studio guest has been the Minister of Information and Communication, Alhaji Ibrahim Ben Kagbo, the government's official spokesperson. I guess it has been a fine evening. Do join me again on Tuesday night for another edition of The Tonight Show, starting at 8:15 p.m. Do have a pleasant night, and don't forget to send your comments to www.facebook.com/thetonightshow.slbc or www.twitter.com/edwardarena. Or you can send your text message to +232 78 546 474. If you miss all or part of the show, you can still listen to it online by clicking the YouTube link on either Twitter or Facebook. My name is Edward Alicia Serena. Good night.